second thought, I should have seen this before Ramadan. And now I saw this in the first day of Ramadan. Well, it's fine because it's a superhero movie, so what could go wrong? Pushing like we used to do. Deadpool 2 is the sequel to the first Deadpool movie, and this movie is not directed by Tim Miller, and now it is directed by David Leitch. Now in this movie, Deadpool 2 continues the story of Deadpool, where he becomes the greatest American hero that we've ever seen. And now he has been a boy with the name of Firefist, or we can call him Russell, who is now being hunted by the guy played by Thanos, Josh Brolin, who plays as Cable, who is now planning to kill Russell for some reason. And now in order to do that, Deadpool must save that kid in many ways. So what they have to do is that they create a team and try to find a way to stop Cable from doing it. Well, there's not much I can say about it, but that's just a plot line that I can say, because that's not the actual plot, so there's a plot twist to it. Now, to be honest, my plan was to see this on a day before Ramadan. Now that today is Ramadan, well, happy Ramadan to all of you. So I can tell you that I had to see this, I had to fix my grades, and then I didn't get to watch Deadpool 2. I mean, the tickets were not out. I mean, I can still watch it, but nah, I don't know about watching alone, so I'm gonna have to watch it with my brother instead. So I watch it in IMAX, I watch it with my brother without eating popcorn. Well, that's fine, because I gave my money and use it to buy something else. But don't worry, at least I saw Deadpool 2. Now I might probably save my money to get Venom instead, but probably I'll watch Ant-Man and the Wasp with my family, so that's not a big deal. I know I haven't been making videos in a long time, but I still got some grades to catch up, so I'll stay tuned for that. Now, from the beginning till the end of the movie, I would say that the beginning is similar to the whole movie. And yeah, in the middle we get some action scenes, and in the ending there's some great parts about the ending of the movie. Now I have to say that I like all the elements in this movie. I like the humor that they have in this movie. There are some great humors that they have in this movie. I like the humors, and they have some references in this movie. So what I can say about that is that this movie is very different from the first movie. If you compare it to the first Deadpool movie, this movie is more of an action movie, and it's still great at all because you get the action, you get the fun in this movie, you can also get the humor in this movie. And this movie is actually 2 times better than the first movie. This time you have everything. You have a family story, you have a love story. Deadpool 1 was more of a love story, and it's more of a simple story. You basically, a girl is being kidnapped, and then this guy turns into something else, and now he's using that powers to save his girl. Now in the sequel, he's using it for something else. Deadpool does the story more on Wade Wilson and what's it like to be Deadpool, and now that he's facing with a time traveling mutant known as Cable, who's trying to go against a kid. And now Deadpool has some issues with this kid, and now Deadpool must go create a team, basically talk with the people he knows, and then try to stop Cable. Now I had a fun time watching this movie. I'm not like, oh no, I'm gonna get bad sins for watching this movie, but hey, overall it's fine. I mean, I know it's violent, but I'm mature enough to watch this movie. Yeah, the movie was really fine. I mean, it was really violent as well. It was very hilarious. There are some hilarious moments in this movie. There are some cameos which will really surprise you. I mean, I saw Stan Lee, that's for sure. Not just Stan Lee, but there's more than that. Just imagine one of the X-Men movies that you watched back in the days. Oh god, I just see the cameo. There's an amazing cameo. And as well, the post-credits. There's post-credits. Now, there's no after-credits, but there is a post-credits. You know, like, the credits, like, right after directed by that. And then before the cast part. It's very amazing. You want to see that. It's very amazing. It's very respectful. It's very similar. You're like, yeah, why not? Let's not why doing that. And I really like how the elements in the movie, you get the storyline, it's great. You get some great characters, which we'll talk about the characters in a moment. And I have to say that watching Deadpool 2, I feel like Deadpool 2 was really better than the first movie. The first movie was simple, but the second movie, it's very better than the first movie. Now let's talk about the character. Ryan Reynolds is still the anti-hero Deadpool, and Deadpool is much more funnier. Sometimes you get to see him off mask and on mask, but sometimes seeing him on mask is much more hilarious. But seeing him off mask is basically what he used to be. He's showing his true nature, his true natural form of what it's like to be non-mask, and now he's trying to deal with many things. Well, it's actually a funny thing. You also got Cable in here. Cable is basically like the main villain, but I did a little bit of a research. Well, he's not actually the villain in the comics, but he is in the comics, which is actually not, which might be a plot twist actually. You're probably like confused, wait, is he a good guy or a bad guy in the comics? Well, there's actually a reason why he did that, why he's planning to kill Russell, basically, because Cable is now filled with his mind with murder, and there's actually a backstory to why Cable is wanting to kill Russell, which I would say is something. Russell is played by a 15-year-old New Zealand actor who's at the same age as me, but I think I'm more older than him. However, I can say about this guy that basically, Firefist, yeah, he's a fat person just like me, and sometimes he has like feelings, he has emotions, and he's basically Firefist. Yes, he has fires in his head, and then he will just burn everything, but he's really an emotional kid, so there's a reason why sometimes Deadpool has a little bit problems with him. We also got the X-Force. Wow, the X-Force. for such a great band. Painter is great. You get Pennywise, but we'll see who's lucky out of the ball. It's basically Domino. I got back watching Deadpool 2, and then suddenly I got Domino's Pizza, which is actually a lucky thing. Well, yeah, I tell you what, Domino, yes, his superpowers is lucky, just like what she said. But there's a reason why she's lucky, because she never gets killed. Every time she passes through explosion, yes, she will never pass through it. It's kind of like Final Destination. You gotta predict that someone's gonna die because of this. But this time, Domino's like the side, like the guy who's gonna win out of everyone in Final Destination. You also got Dopinder, which is the Indian taxi driver who's still great in this movie. Yes, Dopinder is still the funny part of this. He's still a part of it, and I still like having him in this movie. You also got Colossus and Negasonic Teenage Warhead. And I know Negasonic doesn't do much in this movie, even though she went to my country and I did get to meet her. But there's something that really pisses me off, which I'm like, yeah, that's fine, basically. But Colossus, yes, Colossus is still a funny thing. Colossus is still the bright side of it, and I really like how him. I have to say this, but Deadpool 2 is an epic sequel to the Merkin Amount with its greatest ways. I really like the first Deadpool movie. I mean, I have Deadpool on DVD, and I'd say it was okay. When I was watching this movie, I watched this on Ramadhan, and now I watch Deadpool 2 on Ramadhan. I have to say, compared to the first Deadpool movie, this is actually 2 times better, because the bigger the better. And speaking of bigger better, I watch this in IMAX, but I would say the bigger the better, the spectacular in IMAX. Yes, Deadpool was really fun to watch this movie. I really had a fun time watching this movie, and now next week I'm gonna catch up with Solo Star Wars Story, which might be another late review as well. The problem is I'm at the week where I'm gonna face the so-called cutoff date, which is basically my day of fixing grades and all that. And then don't worry, I might get an early release for Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. And then on summer, I can be back on making videos as long as I don't have summer school, because I really don't want to get a summer school. So now that I got my money spent on something else instead of watching Deadpool 2, I guess I'm just gonna save my money for Venom. But yeah, that was my review on Deadpool 2. Have you seen it? What do you think of the review? Let me know in the comment below. And yeah, now that it's Ramadan, those who are celebrating Ramadan, happy Ramadan. Hopefully I'm satisfied to make you happy. So yeah, I'm gonna hang out with you during the Ramadan. And yeah, that was my review on Deadpool 2. Here's the outro. That is all for this video. If you do enjoy this video, give it a like. That would be very helpful. And in the description, you'll find two links so you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Google+. I appreciate you guys for watching this. And I'll see you another time. Bye-bye.